Hi everyone, my name is Dipankar and I'm an R&D advocate at Qlik. Today we are going to learn how to use the Nebula CLI to build and deploy an extension to QlikSense. Let's jump in.
In this video, we are going to use the Nebula CLI to develop and deploy a simple visualization extension. The objective is to give an idea of how easily and fast we can build extension using Nebula CLI. So we'll keep the implementation very basic. Let's get started. First, we have to globally install the Nebula CLI command, and to do that, we'll use npm. And the command would be this. Okay, there is a typo, but I'm gonna fix it. Perfect. So this command will help us to proceed with all the other commands that will be required for us to build and finally deploy a visualization. All right. So the next step would be to get started with creating a new Nebula visualization. And to do that, we'll use the command nebula create. Please make sure to give a particular visualization name. So in this case, it'd be like DemoVis for us. All right. So now the nebula create commands basically gives you three options, which would be like you can just select a Picasso template, you can just select a bar chart, or you can just not select anything and just go with your own templates. In this case, I'll just use a bar chart. So now, as you can see, all the required Picasso bar chart files and the dependencies are getting installed. If you open the folder, you can see that we have the source and we can also see our, the main JavaScript file where we'll have our extension and everything, specifically the Picasso ones, and how we are creating a bar chart here. All right, let's get back and see how much it has installed. Okay, it's still getting installed. All right, let's give it a couple more minutes before we move on to like create our visualization. All right, perfect. So now we will just get into the folder, and the next command would be for us to like start with a local development server. So the command to start your own development server is nebula serve. And this would compile everything and try to like, you know, give any error if there is any. Otherwise, it will allow you to like start your own development server at this particular port. So I'll go to this particular URL in my browser and start it. Okay, now we are in the interface where we can connect and see the extension editor and visualize the extension that we are developing. So I will use a previous connection that I have and select one of the apps that I want to like use this extension with. All right, so our extension code is basically a bar chart. As you can see from here, we are using a bar chart, and we are basically using the bar chart to like use it as an extension in our case. So I'll add my dimension, basically take a dimension, let's say decade, and the measure of number of movies. Great. So now we have the extension that we created using the Picasso template. And our next step would be to deploy this particular extension. So to do that, the next command in the CLI would be nebula sense. So this would convert all the packages that we have in a particular format. All right. Let's see, it should be included. Okay, that's fine. I mean, we don't need the package in JSON. And if you can see here now, now we have something called DemoVis extension, and this basically have all the QEXT and the JavaScript file that we can use it as an extension for QlikSense environment. So let's just zip it up before we put it into our extension folders. So I'll just compress it. All right, and now I'll go to my console in the management console and go to the extensions, and we'll upload this particular file here. All right, let's add it. All right, it's successfully uploaded now. Now I'll go to the app and just refresh it to get the latest extension that we uploaded. Perfect. Let's go to the custom object and extension, and it was called test chart for me. So I'll just click the test chart here. All right, and now we'll add the dimension and the measure. Perfect. So you can see how faster and easily you could build an extension using the Nebula CLI. And I hope it was really helpful. Thank you so much.